There are two types of standalone InTouch applications. These can be created and managed using the InTouch Application Manager. A standalone application is file-based, consisting of a primary folder containing subfolders and files, which can be copied anywhere. This type of application is built with the InTouch editor called Window Maker and run with InTouch Window Viewer. The first type of standalone InTouch application is the native application. This is the most commonly used application type because it supports both legacy graphics and industrial graphics. Legacy graphics are a rasterized older type of graphic. Industrial graphics are vector-based graphics, which are extensible, scalable, capable of pan and zoom, and shared in common across AVEVA visualization products. The second type of standalone InTouch application is the legacy application type. It is available for backward compatibility and supports only legacy graphics. The legacy application type does not support industrial graphics. Often confused as an InTouch application type, but more an architectural configuration, is the InTouch Tag Server. What is an InTouch Tag Server? An InTouch Tag Server is an InTouch application configured with only tags and serves as a data source for other InTouch applications containing graphics. Why use a tag server? You reduce network traffic. You reduce demand and bandwidth for I/O devices, especially important on older, slower infrastructure. And you simplify complex client server strategy through I/O aggregation. To understand how InTouch Tag Server works, we must understand how InTouch traditionally connects to field devices. An I/O access server pulls field devices and caches the data values, and then when InTouch runtime applications connect to the I/O access server, they retrieve these data values. Now let's compare traditional InTouch I/O connectivity versus InTouch Tag Server. A typical factory network is usually separated into two parts: the plant network, which is usually high-speed Ethernet, and then the device communications on the plant floor, which may include older infrastructure sensitive to heavy traffic loads, as it was never designed to support the additional bandwidth for SCADA or supervisory control and HMI. Each visualization node requires at least one or more connections to each source of data. Add additional operator stations, and the demand may swamp older equipment, which may lack caching or queuing features for regulating additional demand. If a business grows then from just a couple of workstations to an enterprise, it's possible even the plant floor will suffer. The network burden is one to many for every visualization node added. The solution is the tag server. A tag server centralizes the point-to-point I/O communications. This means that each visualization node need only make a single connection to the tag server. The tag server then makes a connection to each data source. For example here, five InTouch nodes connecting to five data sources, the demand on the plant network is reduced potentially 80% and more due to the efficiency of the window viewer to window viewer communication. Whereas the demand on the back-end data sources is the difference between crashing this old infrastructure and a working system. The tag server makes a request for fresh data from the plant equipment and caches the response. Then the tag server handles multiple requests for the same values from many clients. If the value hasn't changed from each subsequent client request, that same value is served the latest value from the cache. All of this results in a tremendous reduction in bandwidth and network load. InTouch is extensible with a list too vast to cover in detail. But to give some examples, AVEVA applications such as Pi Historian, MES Simulation, Recipe and Batch Engineering, AI, AR, AVEVA Cloud Services, peripheral devices such as GPS scanners, such as barcode and QR code, connection to a vast list of I/O devices, PLCs, RTUs, DCSs, and IoT, database connectivity, and third-party software and apps.